Gobi, a 1.3 million square kilometers barren land space between northern China and southern Mongolia, is the fastest growing desert in the world. And according to experts, around 3,621 kilometers of grassland are lost to this naturally occurring phenomenon, which threatens to collapse China's agricultural economy and food supplies. However, a coalition of Chinese scientists, the government, and local farmers are fighting back against this common enemy with some of the most unprecedented techniques ever seen. Join us in today's video as we reveal how China has shocked the global science community by modifying nature and creating vegetation in one of the world's driest deserts. How bad is the desertification problem in China? And why is China building another Great Wall? Let's find out together. Unlike the Sahara or Arabian Desert, which has sand dunes spread over it, much of the Gobi Desert landscape is covered with volcanic rocks, about 95% to be precise. Located in one of the most remote regions in Asia, Gobi, which means waterless place, in Mongolia, also features some of the most extreme and contrasting temperatures even for a desert. Average temperatures range from as low as negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit in January to potential 113 degrees Fahrenheit in July, although daily temperature could be much higher in some rare cases. Annual total precipitation also varies as well, ranging from less than 50 millimeters in the west to around 200 millimeters or 8 inches in the northeast. Due to this contrasting harsh climate condition, some parts of the Gobi Desert only witness rain once in 3 years. Sounds really bad, yeah? But then, how bad is China's desertification problem? Well, China's desertification problem is more far-reaching than you think. The Asian giant is the world's third largest country by landmass, only behind Russia and Canada. For perspective, China's over 9.5 million landmass spans 5 geographical time zones and borders 14 countries across 4 continents. China is 39 times bigger than the United Kingdom, covering exactly 1.88% of the world's entire land surface area. This sounds like a whole lot of space on paper, and in reality, it is. But what if we told you that only 1.28 million square kilometers, or approximately 13% of China's landmass, supports agriculture? Deserts such as the Badain, Jaran, and Gobi make up 28% of landmass, while mountains cover 58%. Together, they dominate more than 80% of China's land surface area. This has had a direct impact on the lives of 400 million citizens. It's clear that the Gobi Desert is just one of China's numerous desertification issues, but it's a significant problem that must be tackled if China wants to maintain its current economic growth trajectory. So, what is China doing to prevent the spread of this desert? According to experts, climate change and human economic activities are responsible for the country's land degradation and desertification problems. But thankfully, it's a problem that human and scientific activities can reverse. China is deploying its full technological strength against this menace. But the Asian giant is getting some external help as well. In 2012, the World Bank started an $80 million project in China's Ningxia province to restore natural vegetation, decrease desertification, and execute other environmental protection measures. Ningxia is located in northern China and is surrounded by 3 major deserts. Before the World Bank initiative, the region has been battling aggressive desertification for more than 60 years. As of 2010, nearly 3 million hectares, or 57% of the area, had been directly affected by land degradation or desertification, encroaching farmlands and villages. But improvements have been made since the World Bank project launched. For example, the Bajitan Forest Farm in Lingwu County received just 160 millimeters of annual rainfall and an evaporation rate of almost 2,000 millimeters. Also, high winds blew an enormous amount of sand into the nearby Yellow River, increasing the riverbed level and flood risks. A portion of the $80 million grant was set aside to tackle this problem. Meanwhile, a 1+4 technique derived based on the data and experience gathered by the experts in the last 6 decades is being used to restore vegetation. One in this equation refers to using a straw checkerboard to fix the sand, which acts as the foundation, while 4 represents the planting season, spring and autumn, and other supplementary efforts involved, including spot sowing, container seeding, and broadcast seeding. Since adopting this method, farmers within the region have seen the survival rate of plants increase to 70%, and vegetation cover has spiked by 40%. Essentially, the rampaging sand dunes have been halted, and more than 6,000 hectares of desertified areas have been put under control. Thanks to the 1+4 model, a once sandy area in Sanchi County, also on the Maowusu Desert's boundary, is now blossoming with trees and grass. In addition, forest cover has surged by 2%, old pasture grasses have resurfaced, and the region now experiences an average of 11 dusty days annually. Crucially, the Straw Checkerboard initiative has created more economic opportunities for citizens. During the program, officials paid out around 70 million yuan, or $10 million, to farmers who make straw checkerboards. In 2016, researchers at the Chongqing Jiaotong University announced the invention of a novel AI technology that facilitates the conversion of deserts into farmlands. This technology uses a plant cellulose paste to improve the quality of desert sands so that they can hold water, minerals, air, microorganisms, and other nutrients necessary for plant growth. A trial was conducted with this magical paste on a 1.6-hectare plot in the Ulan Bush Desert, and the results were astonishing. The dry land became fertile and was used to grow different crops, including corn, rice, sunflowers, watermelon, and tomatoes. Interestingly, scientists used the same volume of water and less amount of fertilizer required to grow crops on normal land, but the plants still produce a higher crop yield than those planted on arable soils. And according to Professor Yang Qingguo of the Jiaotong University, the cost of artificial materials and machines for transforming sand into the soil is lower compared with controlled environmental agriculture and reclamation. In the short term, converting deserts to farmland through scientific means will boost the economy by aiding agriculture, reforestation, and natural resource management. But in the long run, it could have devastating effects on the climate and ecological balance. If you have reached this far in the video, we would like to give you a huge thanks. You can extend your support by subscribing to the channel and turning that notification bell on, so you don't miss any of the content we upload. Comment down below, "I subbed," for your chance to be entered into our monthly shout-out giveaway. The efforts made so far by Chinese scientists are commendable. However, the land degradation and desertification issues are not completely solved. But not to worry, because China has yet another plan to combat this stubborn problem. It is not a simple plan, though. It involves building a wall just like the Great Wall of China that exists already. Why is China building another Great Wall? You've probably heard about the Great Wall of China. Yeah, the same one that took 2 millennia to build, and stretches 21,198.18 kilometers, all the way from northern China to southern Mongolia. It measures more than half the length of the Earth's equator. But that's by the way. The real news is China is building another one, but this time it's going to be called the Green Great Wall of China, because instead of bricks, the Chinese government is building a barrier made of trees against desertification. The idea to erect an ecological wall is part of the Three North Shelter Forest program launched in 1978. It entails planting a wall of trees across a land space of 4,506 kilometers to stop the Gobi Desert from spreading into other areas. So far, over 66 billion trees have been planted, representing the world's largest artificial forest. But despite these huge efforts, experts remain doubtful about the overall effects of the project because, on one hand, desertification has been halted in some areas, but it has continued to gain ground in others. A study shows that only 15% of the trees planted in 1978 survived till 2004. But all the same, the initiative is very helpful given that China's mangrove forest has retracted by 40% since the mid-90s, and over 20% of vertebrate animal species in the country risk going extinct. Scientists across the world have struggled to deal with the degradation and desertification. One alarming report claims that 41.3% of the Earth is covered by deserts, affecting more than 3 billion people worldwide. Chinese scientists seem to have found a good solution to this menace, and hopefully their colleagues across the world can learn and implement these techniques in their respective countries to reverse the negative climate change trend that we're currently experiencing, and make the world a better place. What do you make of China's intention to build a Green Great Wall? Should other countries adopt this initiative? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section. Be sure to check out this video over here.